And he continually, coming on as a substitute that day, took on Tony DiRigo and caused Leeds problems. No DiRigo, of course, today. He went off injured in the first half. But Donoghue has got terrific pace and the ability to cross the ball well. Played in a League Cup final many years ago for Norwich City.
It's a positive move, that, Alan, isn't it, by Barry Fry? He's decided that, you know, they've messed around long enough, but they've only got 45 to go. Let's go at Leeds and see if we can get that all-important goal.
White has had another good, steady game for Birmingham against his old club. Had the misfortune, of course, to score that own goal, which decided the first leg. And Yeboah flicked it straight to White this time. Now Francis getting in behind the penultimate defender. And managing to find Richardson. That's good play by Dean. Saw the danger and got there before Donoghue could.
Redeemed himself in the eyes of the fans with that interception, didn't he?
And does the same again, dispossessing Poole this time and ensuring it's going to be a goal kick for Leeds.
Mind you, we were talking at the start of the game, the pace that he's got, he ran past the fullback with no problem. He hasn't done it since the first 5 minutes of the game. Now, I would think Leeds, all they have to do, get the ball out to Brian Dean and say, look, have a go at the fullback and get some crosses in.
Dean's header and cleared first time by Sheridan. Claridge. He's won the throw in off Beasley. Poole. Looks for Francis in the middle and it almost found him. It has found Richardson. That was a great opportunity for Birmingham to draw level on aggregate, but Lukic made a splendid reaction save.
What a super chance this was for Birmingham to get themselves level and aggregate. He's got all the time in the world, has time to steady it, and bang, good save by Lukic. But a bad miss, I thought, Alan.
Sheridan's corner, and it came off the defender's head. Lukic did well then under pressure to get it clear. Here's Donoghue. Great effort. And Lukic again was in the perfect place.
Well, we read enough about a positive attitude by Birmingham in this half, and already they've shown up. Chances again here, and a nice little strike at goal. And Lukic had to be on his toes again.
And White has to defend at the other end, and does so. Not too tidily, but certainly effectively. And it will have alarmed Leeds United, the closest they came there to conceding a goal in this game. Kelly's cross, McAllister is underneath it. This is Masinga. The clearance by Johnson. And Johnson again first to reach it. Beasley doing well. Palmer takes over. Weatherall. Strange ball by Weatherall, knocking it back all to 30, 40 yards for Lukic. Home supporters didn't like that. They thought it was a bit negative. But remember, Leeds have the vital goal. The aggregate lead, 2-1. Edwards for Birmingham, finding Sheridan. This is Frayn. Claridge out on his left. Frayn goes it alone. It wasn't a bad effort from that range, but never likely to beat Lukic.
Well, there was a lot of pace on it, Alan, I'll tell you that. And I mean, had it gone on the goalkeeper's left-hand side, he might have gone in.
Yeboah with a splendid header, but Johnson covering well. However, he's given it straight back to the Leeds man. This is danger area for Yeboah, and it reaches McAllister. Great save, but turned in by Masinga. Nine minutes into the second half, The South African international Phil Masinga scores the goal that might well send Leeds United to Wembley.
A bit lucky in a way there, first of all, Gary getting the break, but the goalkeeper made a great save, and Masinga up there just to roll it into the empty net. McAllister hasn't been getting forward much at all in the game, but he certainly got forward there, almost scores himself to make it easy for Masinga.
Only his second goal of the season, and the other one came in the quarter-final of the Coca-Cola Cup against Reading. In fact, it's only the fifth game he started all season, Masinga. And what a valuable, valuable goal that could be. With the prospect of a Wembley final, and of course the prospect of a place in Europe next season, now suddenly opening up before Leeds United. And Howard Wilkinson, who has never taken a team to Wembley in his long career in management, must be mightily relieved that that goal has made things look a lot more secure now for Leeds United. They lead 3-1 on aggregate. And Phil Masinga, who cost £250,000 cheap by today's standards, will certainly recoup that and more if this proves to be the goal that sends Leeds to the final. Kelly's free kick is a good one. Dean wins the header, and he's there again, and a chance for Yeboah! Two goals in 3 minutes, and Howard Wilkinson can start thinking about Wembley now. Tony Yeboah, with his 17th goal of the season, has made a trip to the famous stadium. And near certainty.
Well done, Brian Dean there. Got the first header, got the second header, and Yeboah, acrobatic scissor kick, knocks it in the net. There's Big Brian, up he goes with the second one. Yeboah, bicycle kick in the corner.
It's Leeds United 2, Birmingham City 0. 4-1 now to the Premiership side on aggregate. And Tony Yeboah and the international teammates he has all around him here at Ellen Road can count on a trip to London in a month's time to face Aston Villa.
A bit of a mix and match game, hasn't he, Big Brian Dean? He got a little bit of luck there. McAllister's cross deflected on his head and he just buried it in there at the back post. You see here, there's a cross going in, there's a flick off a defender. Brian Dean, well over 6 feet, up he goes, nods it down.
His sixth goal of the season. And the aggregate score now, 5-1 for the team from the Premiership. After a long, long wait, 23 years, Leeds United are back again at English football's most famous ground. Not since the days of Jack Charlton, in fact, in 1973, in the FA Cup final when they faced Arsenal, have Leeds played in a showpiece final at Wembley. Well, for one of the great clubs of English football, it's been a long, long time since Leeds United graced Wembley Stadium. And they're going to enjoy the fourth of that match against Aston Villa. And fortunately, because the Coca-Cola Cup is one of the more democratic competitions, can I say, there's the likelihood that most of these fans will get a ticket, unlike the FA Cup final. And don't forget, if you're a Leeds fan, a Villa fan, or simply a football fan, you can see the whole game live on ITV. Here's Brolin. Clearance by Edwards. Freeman gets it away, but only as far as Radebe. He'll leave it to Carlton Palmer. Dean. A lot of room opening up for Dean. Ooh, he hit that with real power. Not quite so much accuracy, but a good effort.
A lot of power, as you say, in that one, Alan, wasn't it? A good run at it. I mean, it just opened up and let him come in.
McAllister. They're playing time being added for stoppages now, as Radebe gets it clear to Palmer. Here's Wallace. Lovely little touch back to him. And Wallace fancied a piece of the goal-scoring action himself then.
Yeah, it's two or three shots in the last sort of 15 minutes, little Rodney. Once he got on the score sheet.
Crane. Dorian's a little flick on, but it's gone straight to Kelly. Claridge dispossessing him. Now Donowa. Crane. And now Bowen. Is Frayne again. Carriage onside. Where was he? No. The linesman in fact has flag. He's offside. Leeds United are at Wembley. League champions 4 years ago. Now they can turn their thoughts to winning another of English football's major prizes. Gary McAllister had his usual marvellous game, and Howard Wilkinson, having been three times a loser in semi-finals, is at long last a winner and will lead his team out in a month's time at Wembley against Aston Villa. Steve Claridge missing a penalty on what might have been his final appearance for Birmingham. But over the two games, you have to say, the Premiership quality won the day. A hug of delight for the manager from Carlton Palmer, and Nigel Worthington not involved in the squad today. Brian Dean, one of the goal scorers. And Leeds United can celebrate for a month at least before the reality of facing one of the division's in-form teams of the season, Aston Villa, in one of the showpiece occasions. The Coca-Cola Cup final. We'll be back after the break with an analysis, with the news and views and interviews, and also a look at the Ensley League First Division highlights. Stay with us.
3-0 on the day, 5-1 on aggregate. Let's hear from their captain, Gary McAllister. He's with Gary Newbottom.